The battle plans are being drawn up for all-out war in the state's schools, the sort we haven't seen in decades.
Teachers are accusing the O'Farrell government of devising an underhanded plan to slash school budgets.
Ten's John Hill is breaking this story tonight, and John, this could get very, very nasty indeed.
Absolutely, Sandra. The state government and the Teachers Federation are gearing up for a huge fight over this issue of giving local school principals power over local budgets. Both sides say this is a line in the sand issue, and so far, neither are prepared to budge.
It's a dispute that could cause chaos in government schools for the rest of the year.
This is going to be the stoush from hell. It's going to draw blood from the O'Farrell government.
Teachers are declaring war on the state government over its new policy giving principals control of school budgets. The government claims it's designed to help educational outcomes, but teachers say it's not about education, it's about money.
Public school principals are having devolved to them the responsibility to deliver the savings on behalf of Treasury.
Suggestions of widespread casualisation of the teaching workforce are unfounded, irresponsible and untrue.
The government denies it's planning to force school principals to slash local budgets, but...
Where we can do things more efficiently, of course we do it that way. It's always been the case, whether it's a coalition government or a Labor government.
The teachers' union fears the changes will lead to job losses, increased class sizes, cuts to cleaning and maintenance, and school closures.
The mood of the membership is one of great despair, concern, anger, the lack of detail, and the fact that they are being deliberately deceived on this issue.
They're G'ing up their members against these reforms. By giving them misinformation. That's what I call dishonest.
The union's not ruling out industrial action, even at the risk of being hit with fines of more than $100,000.
But we'll use everything that we can do legally to protect our members and the rights and the learning conditions of our students.
Now, I'm told the teachers are angry and will fight, and they're gearing up right now. There's meetings going on around the state. I'm told by a Teachers Federation official this afternoon that the union regards this dispute as being even worse than that very divisive Greiner-Metherill dispute of the early 1990s.
John Hill, thank you.